When you think about cars, trucks, and SUVs, chances are your mind jumps to names like Chevrolet, Cadillac, and of course, GMC's larger-than-life Hummer EV. But what if I told you that the same company behind these everyday rides is also hard at work on a vehicle that won't ever roll down your street, won't sit in traffic, and definitely won't pull up next to you at the gas station? Instead, this machine is being designed for a place far, far away from Earth, on the dusty, uneven, and hostile surface of the Moon. Sounds wild, doesn't it? Yet that's exactly what General Motors, or GM, is doing right now as part of NASA's ambitious Artemis program. GM isn't new to space travel. Believe it or not, it had a hand in the original lunar rovers that astronauts used during the Apollo missions more than 50 years ago. Back then, these buggies gave astronauts the freedom to explore areas far beyond their landing sites, making those iconic moonwalks even more memorable. Now, history is repeating itself in a big way. NASA has a new generation of crewed moon missions on the horizon, and that means it needs a new lunar rover, something tougher, more advanced, and built for longer missions than anything the Apollo era could have dreamed up. GM clearly wants to be the one holding the keys to that future. The rover prototype GM is working on right now is nicknamed the Eagle. But here's the fun twist. It's not just GM going solo. This project is the brainchild of a partnership known as the Lunar Dawn Team. Alongside GM, there's Lunar Outpost, a relatively young space company with bold ambitions, the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company. Yes, the same Goodyear that's probably on your car right now. MDA Space and Leidos. Each partner is bringing something valuable to the table. Lunar Outpost is leading the design. Goodyear is working on specialized tires, and GM is responsible for some of the most critical components: the batteries, the vehicle chassis, the suspension, and a suite of autonomous features modeled after its supercruise system. And here's where things get fascinating. GM isn't just tossing in some off-the-shelf car parts and calling it a day. The Eagle rover is going to be all electric, powered by GM's Ultium battery technology. If that name sounds familiar, it's because it's the same family of batteries that powers vehicles like the GMC Hummer EV and Cadillac Lyriq here on Earth. These batteries are built around a chemistry called nickel cobalt manganese aluminum oxide, NCMA, which delivers solid performance and impressive range for EVs we drive every day. On Earth, a Hummer EV can get up to 367 miles of range on a full charge. Of course, the Moon isn't exactly Earth, and GM had to re-engineer these batteries to survive conditions that are downright brutal. Think about it for a second. On the Moon, temperatures can swing to extremes we can barely imagine. During the lunar night, which lasts 14 Earth days, temperatures can plummet to minus 334 degrees Fahrenheit, minus 203 degrees Celsius. That's colder than Antarctica's coldest record by a long shot. On top of that, the Moon has no atmosphere to shield against radiation or sudden shifts in sunlight and shadow. GM's engineers have had to tweak and harden their Ultium batteries so they can not only survive, but continue to operate for years in this punishing environment. The company believes these modified batteries could keep the Eagle rover running for up to 10 years, covering as much as 19,000 miles over its lifespan. For context, that's almost 1,000 times farther than the Apollo rover ever managed. Now, let's talk about how this rover will move. You've probably heard of the Hummer EV's famous crab walk feature. It's this incredible system that allows the truck to move diagonally by turning all four wheels in the same direction. It's a party trick on Earth, but also an immensely practical tool for navigating tight spots. The Eagle is going to take that concept to a whole new level. Instead of three motors like the Hummer, the Eagle will get four independent electric motors, one at each wheel. This setup will allow the rover to crawl, crab walk, and maneuver across the Moon's rugged surface in ways that make the Hummer look tame by comparison. And you'll want that capability up there. Driving on the Moon isn't like driving on Earth. The lower gravity means vehicles can easily become unstable. GM has even pointed out that driving at 30 miles per hour on the moon feels more like 90 miles per hour on Earth. Imagine hitting a bump at that speed without the comforting pull of gravity to keep your wheels planted. To deal with this, GM and Lunar Outpost are baking in stability systems that will let astronauts travel safely without turning their rover into a lunar roller coaster. The design also cleverly places the heavy battery pack inside the chassis. That helps lower the center of gravity, which is crucial when you're crawling over rocks and craters, where one wrong tilt could mean a dangerous tip over. The suspension system, another GM specialty, is being designed to soak up the unique challenges of lunar terrain. It's not like they can call roadside assistance if something goes wrong up there, so everything has to be overbuilt and ridiculously reliable. Still, no matter how detailed the specs sound, sometimes words aren't enough. That's why GM and Lunar Outpost decided to give people here on Earth a chance to see the Eagle up close. At the State Fair of Texas in Dallas, they brought the prototype out and placed it side by side with the GMC Hummer EV. The message couldn't be clearer. The cutting-edge technology that's making its way into electric trucks and SUVs today isn't just about revolutionizing roads and highways. It's also about preparing humanity for its next steps into space. Of course, GM isn't the only company chasing NASA's dream contract. The Eagle is just one of three designs competing for the honor of becoming the Lunar Terrain Vehicle, or LTV. The other two contenders are teams led by Intuitive Machines and Venturi Astrolab. Each has its own take on what a lunar rover should look like and how it should function. NASA hasn't picked a winner yet, but the space agency is expected to announce its decision soon, possibly by the end of the year. What's interesting, though, is that even after a winner is chosen, we won't see the new rover in action for quite a while. NASA's timeline points to Artemis V, which isn't expected to launch until around 2030. That gives whichever team is selected plenty of time to refine, test, and perfect their designs before astronauts depend on them in real lunar missions. And make no mistake, NASA has laid down some strict requirements. Any rover it picks has to carry at least 500 kilograms of cargo, which includes two fully suited astronauts. It also has to have headlights, which might sound like a small detail, but is actually a big first for extraterrestrial vehicles. And of course, a navigation console is essential, because GPS satellites don't exist around the moon. When you step back and think about all of this, it's hard not to get excited. The Apollo rovers were iconic, but they were designed for short stays and limited mobility. The Artemis program is planning something far more ambitious: extended missions where astronauts can explore wide swaths of the lunar surface, set up scientific experiments, and even prepare for the possibility of future missions to Mars. That's why NASA is pushing for a rover that can last a decade, travel thousands of miles, and support serious work. And here's what makes GM's involvement so fascinating. This is a company that built its reputation on muscle cars, pickup trucks, and suburban family SUVs. Now it's leveraging those decades of know-how to create something destined for the moon. It's almost poetic. The same engineering that lets a Hummer EV crab walk out of a tight parking spot is being adapted to help astronauts crab walk across craters on the lunar surface. It's a reminder of how technologies developed for everyday life can end up serving humanity's greatest adventures. So whether GM's Eagle wins the contract or not, the mere fact that we're seeing this kind of crossover between car makers and space exploration is thrilling. It's proof that we're standing on the edge of a new era. Companies that once focused purely on Earth are now thinking bigger, aiming higher, and preparing for challenges that go far beyond highways and city streets. The moon is calling, and it looks like our vehicles are finally ready to answer. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Also, hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future uploads. If you know someone who would enjoy this video as much as you did, share it with them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.